Swear, I'm only counting big bills, big bills. I fell in love with big wheels and quick drills. My money tip drill, can't sit still. Don't give up your fit kill. It makes well, I'm only counting. Don't stress, quattro. Proceed with caution. I heard if you taste it, it only results in a hole in your heart. Now take the whole cake and I won't leave a portion. It's only your organ. Thank God mama couldn't afford it. The loneliest orphan. I flip my misfortune and grow me a fortune. My role is scorching. The hated is slowly endorsing. Now call me important. My beside me like Tommy and Martin. We balling your cotton. The with your like we turning your heart in. She don't need a she from all of the money we counting. Count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up. Count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it. Can't take it when you die, but you can't live without it. Count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it. Can't take it when you die.
It is NBA action on EA Sports. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by Jay Williams. Should be a terrific game here tonight. From American Airlines Center in Dallas, tonight, the Dallas Mavericks playing host to the LA Clippers. Tip won by the Mavericks, and we're underway in Dallas. And count the basket inside.
Strong finish. That's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
Jay, upon scanning this Clippers roster, there are a lot of guards for Doc Rivers to work with.
Yeah, they have a plethora of guards, and if I'm this team and if I'm Doc Rivers, I'm thinking about how do I throw as many guards at you as possible, because Doc wants to get another guard in there to apply the same pressure. They should be the new modern-day Detroit Pistons with the style they play defensively.
On the follow, way to stay with it. That's a strong finish. Regardless of contact, finishing strong is key. Picked up by the Mavericks.
Now push it. Let's attack in transition so we can build this lead.
Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say no foul.
Ah, that transition offense was flawless. When guys fan out and actually fill the lanes with a sense of urgency, you heard me correctly, a sense of urgency, you will get a great shot every possession.
And the slam.
Huh, what a move. But the move never should have happened in the first place, especially if there's communication from the help side defender. You have to let that guy know which way he can force him defensively to where there's help.
KP, Christoph Porzingis, 2 for 2. That's what you want.
When I play and I see guys do this all the time. When you shoot, the target isn't the basket. The target is actually before you even go into the shot. The target are your hands defensively. If your hands are down and you give me clear vision towards the bucket, that shot's definitely going up.
Dallas owns the basketball. Let's it fly from long range. Luka Doncic, marked man. Shot altered and no good. Basket's good on the follow. Way to stay with it.
That's lunch pail business right there. Don't worry about the no call. Keep powering through.
Knocked loose. And that'll get out of bounds off one of the Mavericks. So it'll stay with the LA Clippers. We have both squads set to make some moves right now. Substitutions. Oh, he's denied.
Oh, big man doing work right there.
Lee with the basketball. 10 to 4 is the score. That's good D. Shot no good.
Shoot or shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
Porzingis. Okay, another one goes down. They're right where they want to be.
Exactly. Next play, you have to turn around defensively and get in the stance and actually keep that same kind of tempo.
Great look and vision. Tough shot and nearly a chance at a three-point play. No foul.
Another possession they were forced to take a tough shot. This time they got to go, but they need to do something different to start creating more open look opportunities.
Short jumper off the mark. to Nowitzki. From long range. Oh, he couldn't get it to go. Oh, highlight moves. Tough to pull off with the defender all over you. Short jumper, won't fall. Grabs his own miss and scores. Good concentration.
In the paint, you need to finish. Just like that.
Gets it in the left corner. Nowitzki can't go down. Smothering defense. Beverly into the front court. 5-point game. Patrick Beverly missed his first. That one goes.
You see, here's why versatility is so imperative for your offensive repertoire. If you're a one-trick pony as a defender, I know exactly how to defend you because you only do one thing. But if you have versatility, then the coach can put you in multiple looks within the offense, and then you can get it any way you want it.
To Nowitzki. Finishing inside the paint on that one.
They're going to have to find answers defensively and quickly because he's carving them up in the first quarter.
Beverly into the front court. Down three. And look out.
An easy two. Get back on defense.
And the rebound taken down by the Clippers. Beverly into the front court. They can go two for one if they hurry. He's going to the free throw line to shoot.
Hey, look, sometimes you need to feel out your opponent. Let him know you're there. I'm okay with that early foul.
Danilo Gallinari. He's got two shots coming. A career 86% from the line. No good. Missed them both. To Lee. Nowitzki. His first quarter struggles from deep continue. It's no good. 4-3. Rebound taken down by Porzingis. He'll put it up at the buzzer. Final shot of the period. Almost. It would have counted, but time to turn the page after a close first quarter. Jay, what stood out?
I know you're wondering why I'm clapping. Both teams came out in the first quarter, and they executed. When do you ever see that, Ed? You have to continue to bring those competitive juices into the second quarter, and we're going to have one heck of a ball game.
Beverly into the front court. Down a point. Slam dunk.
Well, they have such great flow to their offense this evening. The ball isn't sticking to one player individually. It's moving around the perimeter, and it's zipping. They're playing with a special cohesiveness.
And scores.
There you go. I like seeing the scoring coming from unlikely sources.
Clippers have the basketball. Beverly. Probing the defense. Beverly. Knock loose. And that'll get out of bounds. Last touch by the Clippers. Mixing things up. Hockey line substitutions. Both teams making changes.
Subbing in for the Clippers, number 20.
Let's it fly from beyond the arc. Not that time. He missed it. Runner here won't go. To Brunson. Going to launch beyond the arc. Knocks it down and the foul. He's going to the line for a chance and a 4-point play.
Oh, that was a big time shot. But more impressive than the shot, the bench reactions. I love the celebration tactics. This is why you love this game.
Zip code.
I mean, this is something everybody can relate to in their lives. It's happened to me while doing broadcasts as well. Sometimes you're physically there, but mentally you're nowhere to be found. We obviously saw one of those same things happen in court.
Williams across the timeline, down 5 to Gilgeous Alexander. Old school, backs his man down for the basket.
You feel that? I see the confidence building.
Fires the 3, and it's rebounded by Green. To Williams. Wide open look, won't go.
This game is all about the small victories, though. The execution on that play was on point. You keep executing like that, those shots are going in eventually.
It's the Clippers with the possession now. Knocked loose. Mavs have it.
Come on, let's dig in. Let's really build this lead.
Lee. That's off the side of the rim. Short. To Lee. Here's a chance from long range. Message received. Well defended. Throws it down. The Mavericks signal for timeout as they'll discuss matters in what's now a 3-point game. Changes coming from both sides right now. Brunson to Lee. For 3, that's how you defend. To Gilgeous Alexander. Too much contact, and free throws coming.
And as a defender, you cannot, I repeat, you cannot foul in the act of upward motion into your shot. Your timing needs to be better.
Shai Gilgeous-Alexander at the line. Can't connect on the first free throw. Good bounce back. Hits the second. It's a 1-of-2 trip. Fires the 3. Still hasn't hit from deep in the first half. No good. Derek Nowitzki, tough shooting, only 2-for-6 after that make.
That's what I'm talking about, and it's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket.
Beverly. Drives, but shot won't go down. Lee with the basketball. They lead it, 4-point game. Porzingis goes to the left side. Beyond the arc for 3. And stays cold from deep as he misses another one. It's no good. Beverly into the front court. Looking to make something happen. Shot from in close. No good. Lee to Luka Doncic. Lets it fly from long range. And a putback slam.
Woo, that's nasty right there.
Loose. Picked up by the Mavericks. Scooped up. Going the other way. To Luka Doncic. Has a chance. Keep on trying. Shots no good there. Count the 2 for KP at the rim.
As my mother would say to the defender, A for effort, F for results.
Knocked loose. Mavs have it. Lee to Brunson. From long range. Now that's a contest.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Patrick Beverly. He is shooting well. He's made 2/3 of his shots.
The okey-doke. Let's see if we'll try that one again.
Unbothered by the defense as he drills it.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball. And there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
4-3. Too easy. Defense has to communicate.
It's all about creating space with the dribble. Once you have that gap, you can beat somebody in a variety of ways. He chose a dagger with a three.
Deep three at the buzzer. Time expires to end the first half. It's the Mavericks with the lead.
The Mavericks have a comfortable lead at the halfway mark. Clearly, the number of three-pointers these guys scored in the first half was incredible. And if they could keep that up, it's going to be tough to keep that Fellas, back to you.
Tight game through the first two quarters as we resume play here in the third. It's L.A. Clippers ball. Yes, and the foul. And a chance at three coming up.
That was such a great job by the offensive player. Knowing that you're probably going to take some lumps here and there, but still remaining aggressive throughout the shot and getting a crack at the extra point.
Free throw good as he finishes off the three-point play. They're back within a bucket. Let's it fly from beyond the arc. Jay, you had to figure sooner or later one of those threes was going to go down.
I don't know. I'm a little bit beside myself that he kept shooting the ball at that clip. I mean, when you miss that many shots in a row, you usually try to get to the rim, see the ball go in, then go inside out. But obviously, that's not the case.
Going to launch beyond the arc. He's not shy about shooting it from out there, but he misses this time. Fires the three. Not going down here. To Luka Doncic. And the rebound taken by the Clippers. To Gilgeous Alexander. And he's going to the line to shoot.
The game is too tight for you to be taking risks like that. You want to avoid foul trouble at all costs.
Shai Gilgeous-Alexander at the line for two shots. Shooting 50%, some yes, some no, in this contest. And he makes the move. To Luka Doncic. Here's a chance from long range. That's off the side of the rim, no good.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get the offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
And he's fouled. Nice move that time, and he's going to the line for two.
This drives me nuts when I see fouls like that being called in a close game. Sometimes you just got to let him play, man.
Off the mark on the first free throw. Missed the second. 0 for 2 to Luka Doncic. For three, Doncic showing why the Mavs traded up to get him.
And they're relentless with these long shots. It just seems like their spacing is perfect. And they come down, they know exactly where they want to be. And they're shooting the ball without hesitation.
To Lee. Nowitzki. Fires the three, buries it on the catch and shoot.
Ed, let me tell you how this one goes. It ain't no fun, but the homies can't have some. Everyone's getting a piece of the rock tonight.
Beverly into the front court. His guy's down by nine. Nice pass to set things up. Slams it down. Jay, let's see if that's a sign for him.
Well, he's been pretty much non-existent the first three quarters. But when you have a play like that, that can get the juices going, and that can help you with your offensive rhythm.
To Beverly. Almost, and he's not getting the call. Doncic to Nowitzki. Beyond the arc for three. Luka Doncic, marked man. Shot altered and no good. To Beverly. Trying to cash in. Beverly shot, no good. To Luka Doncic. Lets it fly from long range. Smothering D. Right through the heart of the defense. The layup is good.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Now a whistle. Dallas will use the timeout. They'll catch their breath in what's now a five-point game. Shifting gears, here come some substitutions. Lee. Deep right corner from long range. Well defended. To Gilgeous Alexander, and he'll head to the line.
I say this a lot, and it's only because coaches harp on it all the time. Read the scouting report. Know who you can and should send to the line. This is a case of knowing a shooter probably had a better chance of hitting a jumper than he does of hitting the free throws.
Missed the second as well. To Brunson. Four three. He was all over.
Shoot or shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
Here comes the screen. It goes down.
Okay. You don't get a 10 for style points, but it worked.
Lee to Brunson. Let's it fly from beyond the arc. That's off the side of the rim. Short. Yes, and a foul. He'll have a chance in the three-point play.
Hey, you ever bail out of something at the last second? That's what I saw right there from the defender. We call that no man's land. They weren't really committed to getting out of the way, committing a hard foul, or taking the brunt of the contact.
Missed it at the line. Nowitzki to Porzingis. Going to launch beyond the arc. Where's the chatter? No one was even close to him.
And it just seems like the defense has lethargic closeouts. You need to close out with more of a sense of urgency. Run them off the three-point line. Make them take a tough two rather than an easy three.
Fires the three. He's been dialed in from long distance. That's now five threes for the game.
Nothing more painful than the next day watching tape, seeing the fact that he got 15 points off three-point shots.
Nice pass to get things going.
And Ed, here's my offensive theory. More touches, more points. This is a fast-paced league. Either the coaches adapt or you'll be left behind.
And look out. Big finish at the rim. Neither side is giving up an inch.
I guarantee you tomorrow on Complex's social feed, that play will have millions of views. And I'm really looking forward to this fourth quarter because the first three have lived up to the billing.
To Williams. Whoa, Williams! Consistent effort. He's at 50%.
This type of game needs to be celebrated. This is the type of culture that is fostered when you play with unselfish players. When you give up a little bit of yourself and you make your teammate look great, that's the difference between winning and losing. So when you see these guys smiling, when you see them giving each other high fives, that's because of the energy that was created from the pass. Pass is one of the most brilliant things we have in this game.
First try at the line, no good. Second one's good. Splits the pair. Fourth quarter, and they watched their halftime lead completely vanish in the third quarter. What happened?
In the next team huddle, you let them know, it's okay. This is a game of ebbs and flows. We need to find a way to regain our energy and get our way back in this ball game.
Gilgeous Alexander. Here comes the screen. Christoph Porzingis snatching it out of the air. That's his third block this evening.
You know, sometimes basketball can become a very beautiful thing to watch. During the regular season, things can get difficult. Energy can be low. The passion at times can even be lower because players are tired, they're fatigued. But today, it's all been good. They're putting in an absolute show with killer efficiency and tremendous effort and intensity.
Nowitzki to Luka Doncic. Here's a chance from long range. Luka Doncic at the line. First one, count it. checking the three. Got it. Three for three. Nice. LA Clippers with the basketball. And they called.
His timing was a tad bit off.
New blood coming in for both sides. Loose. Picked up by the Mavericks.
Don't rush this now. The game's been tight so far.
For three. Not that time. He misses. Right time. Right player.
Can't teach height.
Fires the three. And the rebound brought down by Howell. That is great vision to set it up. Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
This may sound cheesy, but sometimes you just need to sit back, get a tub of popcorn, and just enjoy the show, because that's what you're watching right now.
Well, the hot shooting night continues. That's his sixth three-pointer of this game.
And you got to give him a lot of love. He's been knocking down shot after shot, but what is the defense thinking? Do you want to play in this game? It's probably time you start buckling down.
It with a defender in his space.
You've heard it before. Slow and steady wins the race. This approach might be working out after all.
Beyond the arc for three. Knocks it down.
And this squad just continues to light it up from long range. One of the things I learned about teams like this, teams that fall in love with a three-point shot, as quickly as they built the lead is as quickly as they can lose it if they're over-reliant on the three-point shot.
Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here comes some changes.
He took a chance. That's the right call.
Gilchrist Alexander. Great dish to set it up. To the rim. Lays it up and in.
And the defense keeps sticking to those flare screens. Just don't flare out to the three-point line. Flare to the rim for a lot.
Traber. And the Clippers with the rebound. Gilchrist Alexander. Ah, rocking the rim. Gotta love the rim rockers.
Gotta be careful, though. Don't hang on the rim too long. You might get a tee.
Traber. Another chance. Slams it home on the putback.
This is where I go back into player mode. If a dude starts to try to have 40 points on me, I'm gonna foul out. I'm gonna start hitting him in places he's not used to being hit. I'm trying to do anything to throw him off his game.
Why even try that time?
I'm going to start calling him the windshield wiper, just erasing all the mistakes.
The opposing coach is going to counter, make some changes of his own. Let's it fly from long range. Shot off the mark. Good defense. Gilchrist Alexander, deep left corner from long range. Yes. Or in the case of the defense, not good.
Just because someone is listening to you doesn't mean that they actually hear you. At the end of the game, when players get tired, they listen to what the assignment was, but they didn't hear what it was.
Clippers have the basketball. Knock loose. Mavs have it.
I tried to work the clock here, but you have to take care of the ball in this possession.
Works it up top to Porzingis. A look. And he hits.
Here's what's brilliant about Luka Doncic. Everybody thinks that you need to be fast or be able to iso somebody and create your own shot with your speed or your athleticism or your explosiveness. That is not the case. Doncic is 6'8", 230 pounds. Put that smaller guard on your hip, post him up, walk him down, shoot shots over the top. If you have an uncanny style of play, that game can reward you a ton in this league.
To Luka Doncic. 4-3. He engulfed him that time.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a half-baked crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole. Even to Zubats, couple of free throws on the way. He struggled so far. Nope, first one does not go. Knocks down the second after missing the first. Calls out of bounds. Last touch by Christoph Porzingis. Cleans it up. Rebound for Porzingis. To Luka Doncic. Lets it fly from beyond the arc, cleaning the offensive glass. Nowitzki, he's 3 for 7. Timeout called here by the Clippers, but this game's in the balance, and time is of the essence. Coach is going to shift gears and adjust his matchups. Kristaps Porzingis swats it. Fourth this contest. Get the cameras out. Flash on.
That's going to make a nice post.
Wraps him up. That's intentional. And the ref calls it.
This is a close game and possessions are at a premium. That's a good move to stop the clock.
And now an intentional foul, so they'll send him to the line. 2 free throws here means it's a 3-possession game.
This is why teammates love him. Yeah, that was an aggressive play, but you're also sending a message, setting the tone. You can't half-step on that.
Goes 2 for 2. Now the Clippers call a timeout. It's their second and final one of the last 3 minutes. They cannot stop the clock again. Vision. Oh, you can sense that coming.
There is a premium market for players with that type of hand-eye coordination.
And they're going to play this one out to its conclusion as we get an intentional foul. That means free throws coming up in what is a 7-point game.
Okay, now look over to the sideline and see what the staff is trying to draw up on the next play. That's good clock management thus far.
Able to convert on both free throws. A shot at the buzzer knocks it down from mid-range. The victory to the Mavericks as they take care of business at home. For Jay Williams and all our crew, I'm Ed Cohen saying so long for now. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports.
Here it goes here. And I've got your EA Sports post-game wrap-up. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose. We look forward to seeing you again next time.